Hi, and welcome to this video on solving inequalities with square roots. When solving inequalities with square roots, we need to follow two simple steps. The first step is to solve the inequality for x the same way we would with any other inequality. There's nothing special about this step. But the second step is unique to inequalities with even roots. Today we'll be looking at square roots specifically. The second step is to set whatever is under the radical symbol greater than or equal to 0 and solve for x again. We do this because you cannot have a negative value of x under the square root. In other words, you can't take the square root of a negative number. This will then give us two inequalities that we can then combine to make a compound inequality if the signs are opposite. If the signs are the same, we use the more restrictive inequality. Let's look at a few examples to see what I'm talking about. The square root of x plus 3 is greater than 4. First, we want to solve this inequality for x normally. We do this by following the same steps we would as if we were solving an equation instead of an inequality. We're going to start by squaring both sides. And then we're going to subtract 3 from both sides. This gives us x is greater than 13. Now it's time for our special step. We want to set what is under the radical symbol greater than or equal to 0 and solve for x again. So x plus 3 is under the radical symbol, so we'll set x plus 3 is greater than or equal to 0. So now we're going to subtract 3 from both sides, which gives us x is greater than or equal to negative 3. Since our signs are in the same direction for both inequalities, we choose the more restrictive one as our final answer. X is greater than 13 is more restrictive than x is greater than or equal to negative 3, because according to the second inequality, 0 could be included because it is greater than or equal to negative 3. But it is not truly in our solution set because it is not greater than 13. Therefore, we only want to consider values of x that are greater than 13. Let's try another one. Solve for x. The square root of 2x minus 5 plus 7 is less than 12. We're going to start by subtracting 7 from both sides. So we have the square root of 2x minus 5 is less than 5. Then we're going to square both sides, which gives us 2x minus 5 is less than 25. Add 5 to both sides. 2x is less than 30. And divide by 2 on both sides. X is less than 15. Next, we're going to set 2x minus 5 greater than or equal to 0 and solve for x again. So we're going to add 5 to both sides. We get 2x is greater than or equal to 5 and divide by 2 on both sides. X is greater than or equal to 5 halves. In this example, our inequality signs face opposite directions, so we want to combine them to make a compound inequality. Our final answer is 5 halves is less than or equal to x, which is less than 15. Let's try one more example together. Solve for x normally. Then, solve so what is under the radical is not negative. Since the signs are in the same direction, we choose the more restrictive case as our final answer. X is less than or equal to negative 133. I want to do one more problem before we go, but this time try it on your own. Once I give you the problem, pause the video and solve the inequality yourself. Then, press play and see if your answer matches up with mine. Think you've got it? Let's see. First, we want to solve our inequality normally. Then, we set what is under the radical greater than or equal to 0 and solve for x again. Since our signs are in opposite directions, our final inequality will be a compound inequality. Negative 1 is less than or equal to x is less than 24. Remember, we cannot take the square root of a negative value, which is why we place the expression under the radical to be greater than or equal to 0. This is true of any even root, like a 4th root or an 8th root. However, it is okay to take an odd root of a negative value. For instance, the cube root of negative 8 is negative 2, because negative 2 times negative 2 times negative 2 equals negative 8. If you are asked to solve an inequality with a different even root, follow the same steps we did here. If it is an odd root, you do not have to worry about the second step and can stop after you initially solve the inequality. I hope this video on solving inequalities with square roots was helpful. Thanks for watching and happy studying.